This is Be More Lifestyle.
Well, we're back, Justin. They got you running, don't they?
Oh, man, I'm all over the place. I had a peach sundae, and now we got more stuff.
Well, we got Liz from the American Dairy Association. Hi, Liz.
Hi, Jimmy. Thanks for having me.
Tell us how to make a healthy milkshake.
Sure. First, I just real quick want to say thank you for having me on today. On behalf of the Maryland dairy farmers, we're so excited to be here to talk about the Undeniably Dairy Shake Off in its fourth year.
But so we're going to win.
It's become a tradition, and you guys are a part of it. So
do you have any, are you in judging or anything?
I'm not a judge. I'm impartial today. I can't vote.
I had a $20
vote. Can't do anything.
But you guys have a good chance of winning if tomorrow voting starts live on AmericanDairy.com. So if your viewers want to vote for Justin and Jimmy, go on the website, AmericanDairy.com, to vote for your favorite milkshake.
All right, tell us what we got here.
Yeah,
now.
Real quick, three simple tips to make a healthier milkshake, okay? So there's definitely room for the indulgent ones from time to time, but I'm a dietitian, so fruit first, right? So if you choose local Maryland fruit, we got melons, berries, peaches, things like that, automatically you're adding some natural sweetness, so you don't have to add any added sugar. So you're starting off great off the bat there. Step two is to use a low fat or a reduced fat dairy option. So you can use skim milk, you can use a reduced fat ice cream like vanilla ice cream here, or some Greek yogurt gets you some more protein.
Gotcha.
And you're not sacrificing on taste because you're still adding in that ice cream.
Very good.
Tip three, add some things that I like to call nutritional boosters. So we have things like oats, cocoa powder, flaxseed, cinnamon, peanut butter, honey. These are all things that add a lot of taste, not a lot of different texture, but a lot of taste and nutrition.
And I'm guessing with this, you just put a little bit of these things in, right? Because you don't want to overpower it, is that right?
Minimum amount for maximum impact.
Ooh, I like that. Yes. Minimum amount, maximum impact.
There you go.
I'll be on a
remember
shirt.
That. So what do we have here? What do we have here?
So here I made two healthier versions of a milkshake. We have a chocolate peanut butter banana milkshake and a strawberry watermelon milkshake. So if you guys want to take a sip, feel free.
Since I'm allergic to peanut butter, Justin,
yeah.
I'll give you that.
I'll do this one.
You can make that one with almond butter, too.
That's tasty.
So still tasty, a lot healthier for you, but not sacrificing on that delicious indulgence.
This is very refreshing too.
Thank you.
I like that a lot. Yeah. That's very good. And so we're going to be out making shakes. Are the Undeniably
Dairy
Shake Off is Thursday, September 2nd.
At 2 p.m.
2 p.m.
Right here on the main stage.
All right. And so we're going to be making it, Jim, and
we're going to win.
I know we're going to win. I got you. That's all that matters.
Go ahead and vote AmericanDairy.com. If your viewers go check out that website, starting tomorrow, you can vote for your favorite shake.
And the kids can come out and see live cows here at the fair.
Definitely. Eat some ice cream, have some milkshakes, and thank your Maryland dairy farmer if you see one.
There you go. Buy local, folks. All right, Justin,
stuff.
We ready?
Right, are we wrapping up the show? Lady T, you want to come in here and do...
We've had a good time this evening.
But wait, you guys look like you were having so much fun.
Hold on.
You got to come this way.
I got to come that way. Oh, your corn kids.
There you go.
Well, this looks great. I'm excited. I'm probably going to try to sneak and vote for this. Which milkshake was your favorite?
I can't have peanut butter, so I'm allergic.
So you obviously can. Okay. Well, obviously.
You just got to make sure to tweet and get all of your followers
to get Jimmy and me
so we win.
That's what I need to do. And I definitely will make sure I do that. Who would have thought milkshake at the fair? Mm. I've never had a milkshake at the fair.
And hopefully our milkshake brings all the fans to the fair.
Oh, my gosh.
That's what I want to happen.
That is what's up. I got to pound
you
on
saying?
That one. That
you
was a really
saying?
Good one.
Yeah.
There is so much to do out here. We got the rides behind us.
Yes.
We got the food. We got the animals.
Mm-hmm.
We got nutrition. We
yeah.
got exhibition hall with the air conditioning.
Right, definitely.
What am I missing?
The live bands.
The live bands. And isn't Jesse McCartney supposed to be here tomorrow?
Uh-huh. Yes,
isn't he
is.
Supposed to? Oh, and performing.
Blue Oyster, and Blue Oyster Cult, which is coming up, I think, like Labor Day weekend.
Okay.
And they're the ones who did the More Cowbell song.
Oh, yes. Okay.
Everybody,
so
they should give everybody in the stands a cowbell.
Exactly.
Yes, they
exactly.
should.
We need more cowbell.
Don't fear the
Don't fear more
the
cowbell.
And you get to see live horse racing, too.
Really?
Oh, yeah, really?
I didn't even know that.
And bet on it or no? Because,
look, let me just tell everybody right now.
Uh-huh.
12 days?
12 days.
We're okay. We're not dieting.
That's
we're not
right.
not dieting for 12 days.
That's right.
We'll
12 days of fun.
After Labor Day,
uh-huh.
so we can eat now.
Yes. I want more deep fried Oreos.
Mm, mine
That's all I want.
All right, well, thanks for watching, folks.
Thank you, guys. And make sure you follow us on all of our social media for Be More Lifestyle. And thank you guys for joining us as we're here today at the Maryland State Fair. Till next time, bye.
Bye.
The preceding program was sponsored by the Maryland State Fair.